Welcome to my new video in LINQ Tutorials. Today I will show you how to use the operator of type in a LINQ query. Let's go. This operator filters the elements of an enumerable based on a specified type. It means, it's a filter operator, to filter a sequence of elements. The filter is based on a specific type. For example, if you have an object array, which contains numbers, strings, Boolean, etc. And you want to get only the integer numbers from this array. In this case, you can use this operator. Let's see how to write this operator in both Visual Basic and C#. Let's start with Visual Basic. We have first the sequence, which we want to filter. After that, we set the operator in this way. I only write the operator with brackets. Within the brackets, I added the word of, and then I can set the type I'm searching for. For example, I want to get only string type from the sequence. In this case, I should set the word string at this point. The result will be an enumerable collection, which contains only the string elements from the sequence. Let's see the following example. I have an object array, which contains numbers, strings, and Boolean. I use the operator to get only the integer elements from this array. The result of this query is the following collection, which contains only the integer numbers. This is how to use the operator in Visual Basic. Let's see how to use it in C#. I also have the sequence and the operator. Here I am setting the type I am searching for in this way. After that, I only set empty brackets. We can do the same here also. If we want to filter the sequence for strings, we can set the word string at this point. The result is also the same, a collection of only string items. For example, the same object array. In this example, I want to get Boolean elements. The result of this query is the following collection. This is also how to use the operator in C#. Let's now switch to UiPath to show you an example, how to use the operator in a query. In this example, I will show you how to get specific elements from an array using its data type. I have the following variables. The first one is my array, which is of type object. I use this type so that I can store different data types in this array. The default value for this variable is the following. I use this expression to initialize the array. Let's see how to do that. First, I defined an array of type object. After that, in brackets, I have the number 9, so that I have 10 elements in this array. It means, I have the indexes from 0 to 9. At the end, I define the different elements within curly brackets. As you see, I have numbers, strings, Boolean, and also a DateTime element. I have other variables here, which I want to calculate later. All these variables are of type array. I have integer, string, date, and Boolean. Currently, there are no default values for these variables. I added WriteLine activity here to print out the content of this array, so that you can see which data do I have in this array. This expression is to print out each element in a new line. I will execute it to show you the elements before start writing the queries. As you see, I have these 10 elements in my array. Now I will start writing the queries to get specific elements from this array depending on its type. In the first query, I want to get the integer numbers from my array. Let's see how to do that. First, I will add an assign activity to write the query. I want to store the integer numbers in this array variable. Let's write the query. I have first the array variable, which contains all elements. This is the sequence what I want to filter. After that, I have the operator of type with integer type, to get only integer elements from the array. At the end, I added to array function, to convert the output to array. I will move this activity here. I want now to print out the content of the new array, integer array. Let's execute the code to check the result. As you see, I got only these three elements, which are of type integer. It means I filtered the array to get only integer numbers. Let's now do the same, but to get the strings from the array. For that, I only have to change the type to string. And here I will use the string array variable. I will change the variable here also. Let's execute the code again. As you see, I got only these elements as output, which are of type string. Only these three elements are of type string in the array. So it works also fine. Let's do the same again to get Boolean elements from the array. I want to store the result in this array. And here I have to change the type to Boolean. Here I will use the new array. I will execute the code to check the new result. As you see, I got only the Boolean elements. And now I want to get the elements of type DateTime. For that I will change the array variable here. I will add it also here. Here I will change the type to DateTime. Let's execute the code again. As you see, I got only this element, which is of type DateTime. This is how to use this operator to filter a sequence depending on the type of elements. If we set a type, which we don't have in the sequence, we will get an empty result. It means, we don't get an exception if there are no elements of the type we are searching for. One last point. In some cases you may need to know, which data types do you have in a sequence. To do that you can use a loop activity. But you can also write a LINQ query to do that. For example, the following query is to loop all elements of an array and to get the type of each element. The output will be an array, which contains all available types. If we have a type more than once, we will get it only once, because I am using distinct function here. For example, the following array contains four different types. The output of this query in this case is the following array, which contains these four types. Before ending this video, let me show you the difference between this operator and where operator. I already talked about where operator in another video. If you want to learn more about it, please check this video. So both operators are to filter the data. Where is to filter the data using a condition. Here we set a condition to get specific data from a sequence. For example, I have the following integer array, and I want to get only the numbers, which are greater than 5. OfType operator is also to filter a sequence, but depending on the data type. It means, we only filter using the type of the elements, no matter which data we have. For example, to get only integer numbers from a sequence, which contains different data types. In summary, if you want to filter data in your project using a LINQ query, you can use these two operators. Depending on your need, you can use either where or of type. That's all for today. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you still have any questions, please don't hesitate to write us back. Thanks for watching and have a great day.